Birds are flying by. They're all coming to me right now. You can see the sun's coming out my front door right there. They're flying by the window, here by the sun. I just got done sun-gazing. You saw in my last video. It's important that we're the father figures of this world. We're the father figures of this world. George Michael, the songwriter, is a good song. But we all need to be father figures to everything and everybody around us, to the animals and to the people and the children around us. Remember that.
Most of the time, losing interest in things you once
good
cared about?
Birds. Yes, they are. Pretty little birds. Hi.
me, babies. Good birdies, come to me. Come eat your seeds. Come to your home.
Bunch of birds out here. Watch them. You can hear them pecking and eating. Pigeons and finches. Once with little black and white striped heads, and they're all flying right there. Good birds. Come get your food. There's a call that I do to the birds. That it's a food call. I call it the International Food Call. And I do this, every animal, squirrel, birds, everything comes from around just with this one throat singing call that I do. Ready? I'm going to do it for you. That doesn't sound like a food call. Nothing does, huh? Every time I do that, they all come. Every bird. Good birds. Good little birds. Yes. Keeps me going is these birds and these animals around here and the sun. Oh, I'm singing beautiful music like father figure. That song was in my head. I will be your father figure. You'll trust in me forever. I will be the one who loves you till the end of time. I will be your father figure. Will be the one who loves you. Put your tiny hand in mine. Till the end of time. There's just so many things that we need to take care of. All these birds that I take care of around here, every creature I take care of, every person that I see, I take care of. I share my food with everybody that I see. You know, everything I've ever had, I shared with them. The homeless, when I see them, I always give them money, you know, and now I can't because all the money that I have, it has to go towards my survival, but I still will help people with whatever food I have or whatever I have on me, I'll share with them. I'm not going to give money out because I don't work anymore. So I'll accept donations, but I can't give money out because I'm not working anymore. I quit the system. So I'll share whatever fruits I get and find with you, and whatever food I have with you, and sustenance, and whatever I have with you that I, you know, material-wise, I'll share with you, but I'm not going to give my money away because that's food. I, you know, I need that for $5 could buy a half a bag of rice, you know, and or I could find some fruit and share that with you. You know what I mean? I'm going to do other things that are organic, that take up, that feed my spirit instead of the material world. I'm not going to be buying things a lot either. You know what I mean? I want to regress from most of that. You know what I mean? And go into nature and cooking and camping and fires. I'm going to light a lot of fires and go to camp places and be camping a lot. Get a tent and use my generator and fires and try not even I'm going to try and use fires. I got a little barbecue pit that I found it. That's the kind of stuff you need to be thinking about when you're going to go, you know, I'm detaching from the matrix. I'm going apart from the system here. I want to live with nature. It's not healthy to live the way that we're living. It's going to kill me, you know what I mean? That's what I'm saying. I got, look at this thing I found right here. This is what you need right here, a little barbecue pit. Look at this little barbecue pit. Isn't that nice? You can take this anywhere with you. It's got the safety instructions. You want to keep a nice distance of everything around you and have, you know, just dirt underneath it, no fences or nothing to light anything or wood. Or, you know what I mean? And you don't want to have this with wood in your camp, under your tent with a hood above it because it's got carbon monoxide that comes off it. So you want to be careful of that too. This is what I'm going to use to cook with when I'm out there. One of the things that I'm going to use, and I'm going to have whatever I need out there. I've got money to get whatever I need, and if I don't get money and whatever I need, I'll find it. I'll get it from somewhere. But I think the best thing for all of us to do is go from national park to national park. Go from park to park. Check out the beauty of the world around you and wake people up. That's what I'm going to do in my life. I'm going to take this little thing and cook it. This thing gets hot and you can cook anything on it. There's a nice stove right here. I just put wood in this. I can't even light fires here. They didn't allow it at this apartment. I used to be able to light this thing outside and burn a fire until one of the neighbors caught their apartment on fire and they banned it. Now we can't do this anymore. So I can't light fires here anymore. There's nothing I can do here anymore. There's no reason for me to be here. Life has moved me on to more adventures. There's no adventure here. I need to light fires at night. I need to see some action. That's what I'm going to see. I'm going to see different things, and I'm going to set myself. I'm going to not be afraid. You know, fear is going to hold me back. So I'm going to get a map and start studying where I need to go, and head places that are headed north. And I'm going to be at the Aurora Borealis someday. And I'm going to show you a video of that. I'll be like, hey, the Aurora Borealis is right outside here. Hopefully, I can show you on a video. That's what I want to do. And hopefully, I can meet some people along the way here, and they can video me. I want them to video. If there's anybody who wants to step up and do that, you can come with me and video this whole thing, this whole adventure that I'm going to go on. And we can get, you know, donations along the way and video this whole thing. You know what I mean, too? You know, we will televise the revolution. Why not? You know, and maybe it can be televised. Maybe both sides can meet, you know what I mean, in a televised meeting, because my group is called Haftbau. And I want us to have uniforms. We already do have uniforms. I have a tattoo. That tattoo on my chest, that's the symbol for Haftbau. That big one on my chest, that's on my Haftbau cards. Okay, so that's the symbol for our group right there. Okay, it's a cool symbol, isn't it? Okay, and that's the group that you're going to join. That's going to take back our world. And any Haftbau member is just as important as any police officer or anybody out there. And you protect that Haftbau member with your life. Okay, you join my group and we protect each other with our lives. And we don't like violence. We don't like fighting. But we will stand up against things that are wrong and injustices. And it's humans and animals for the take back of our world. Haftbau, that's the name of the group. Humans and animals for the take back of our world. It's not just human. All you have to do to join is be a human or animal. That's all it takes to join. And the desire to be free. And the desire to be free on this flat earth. And desire to know truth, too. You really, all you have to be is a human and a desire to want to join. But we prefer members that everybody to know the truths of what's going on. So we just want that free world. You know, be free again to the way we were before. Like, get back to the trees that I was talking about. That's all we want, is to get back to our trees. Okay? That's what it's all about. We want to get back to those big trees. Look at my past videos. That's all we're trying to do. That's the goal. But all this comes together here. You know, and planning how to survive in the world and light fires. And, you know, I mean, I don't even want to use my generator if I'm happy, if I can light a fire. Just, I don't know how I'm going to make it each night. Camping sounds fun. Camping sounds way more fun to be out in nature with fires going. And I can light a fire at night. You know what I mean? I could find somewhere in the next few months here when I'm gone. That's not a bad thing that I'm leaving here. This is a good thing. I won't be in this apartment anymore, but I can light a fire at night. I can light a fire where I'm going. I can camp. I can go see beautiful nature and sights and animals and creatures that you're never going to see. I'm going to see things you're never going to see. You know, you got to have the, you know, I'm done. See, but I get adventure out of this. I'm not going to be homeless. And so one of my friends said, you're going to end up dying on the forest floor. I said, no, I'm not going to die on the forest floor. I'm going to go live, man. This is going to be a big adventure like it's supposed to be. You're just afraid. The fear is going to make you die on the forest floor. You know, I'm a survivor, man. I'm a prepper. This is about adventure and excitement. If you're on the flat earth, did you think when you were in those forests before that you had fear in you? You know, you're fearing, you've been in the forest before. Fear is something man never had. We're warriors. We're survivors, man. We survive no matter what, man. Human beings are durable creatures. You survive no matter what, man. We can fight a fire and survive wherever we're at. The fear makes you cower down and die on a forest floor. No way, man. I'm living forever, buddy. And I'm living a good life camping with this thing right here and a bunch of other things. Who's going with me? Let's go have some fun and adventure. Flat power.